And what those poll numbers show is that if you ask someone what they think of President Trump, the answer you will rarely get is, I don't know. Recent poll numbers show that while President Trump's approval overall may be at 45%, among Republicans, it is 90%, a number roughly equal to the Democrats who disapprove of him. So for Ohio Democrats, who will need some Republican votes in November to win, going all in against President Trump may not necessarily be the way to go.
They have to identify themselves as an alternative, not as a we're running against Trump, because definitely he has strong support. And with independents, if you don't give them something to vote for, they're either going to not vote or they're going to vote for the status quo, which in this case is going to be Republicans and President Trump.
The New York Times, along with Gallup, recently tracked the in-party approval rating among presidents and found that among Republicans at this stage of his presidency, Donald Trump's approval rating trailed only George W. Bush's after 9/11. Sutton says for many Republicans, it's about the big picture.
And for President Trump, the big picture for Republicans is he's achieved policy goals related to tax cuts and deregulation. The trade tariffs, they're waiting to see how that goes, but they're not necessarily judging him on that basis. And all the other stuff that we're hearing about in terms of the Russia summit and everything else, they chalk that up to the Washington swamp trying to take him down.
And when you have passions that high on both sides, you have voting blocs who are and will be engaged come November, with independents being the targeted key.
I do think that we're going to see an overall turnout that'll be up compared to 2014 and even 2010. But in terms of where this race goes in Ohio, really it's anybody's guess.
John Kasich, News 5.